Economic managers in the Philippines renewing their calls for senators to ratify the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP, trade deal. The deal is meant to improve market access and improve competitiveness, but it has also raised concerns in the agricultural sector as some fear it would result in the flooding of cheap imports. The Department of Trade and Industry, however, insists the deal will only liberalize 1.9% of the country's total agricultural tariff lines and even less than 1% of the country's total imports. Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Carl Chua also says the country could miss out on a golden opportunity while other ASEAN countries gain from the deal. The Asian Development Bank approves another $400 million or 20.9 billion peso loan for the Philippines. The funds are aimed at helping the Philippines further deepen its domestic capital markets and increase the supply of long-term finance. The ADB says the Philippines needs various sources of long-term financing to support the recovery of its COVID-hit industries, as well as funding for social protection and infrastructure development. It adds the new loan will help the Philippines form an enabling environment that will attract long-term investors. The ADB has loaned the country billions of pesos worth of assistance since the COVID-19 crisis began. Calls to increase wages of workers here in the Philippines continue to grow louder. That's after a recent study of the Commission on Population showed Filipinos need 2 to 3 jobs in order to support a family. POPCOM Executive Director Juan Antonio Perez III also notes he sees little growth in terms of workers' income.
Ang gusto namin sana aralan ng DOLE, iba pang ahensya, kung paano magkaroon ng living wage na patas sa buong Pilipinas, kasi pare-pareho naman ang pangangailangan ng pamilya. Kasi nakikita namin, nahuhuli ang BARM, no? Dalawang trabaho ang kailangan mo dahil ang baba ng minimum wage. No, sana gumawa ng paraan para maitaas kahit unti-unti ang minimum wage. Yung minimum wage noong 2000, ay 6,000 pesos sa pera natin ngayon.
Sa isang buwan.
Ang BARM, ang minimum wage ay 6,000 sa isang buwan.
Okay.
So hindi gumalaw. Dito sa NCR, 7,000 dati, 20 years ago, ang minimum wage. Ngayon, 12,000 na. So 5,000 lang ang tinaas sa loob ng 20 taon. Hindi ka magkakaroon ng bahay at iba pang pangangailangan kung wala kang naiipon.
Labor group Kilusang Maya Uno expresses concern over the recent POPCOM study. It says government should also be alarmed because it shows salaries of workers are not enough.